have been looking forward to this. It is so hot. Yum, I love ice cream on a hot day.
This is good. It's absolutely delicious. Hang on.
Ow. Oh, it's giving me a pain in the head. Have you ever had that before, when ice cream gives you a pain in the head? Oh man, it hurts. Oh, but hang on, it's going. It's gone. How can ice cream do that, huh? How can ice cream give you a pain in the head?
Because it's very cold and it gives you headaches.
It'll hurt your brain.
It's really cold because it's got heaps of sugar.
It makes your brain go all dark.
Because it's too cold.
Hey, some good ideas there. But you know, if this was a cartoon, then the answer would be that every time I looked away, a funny cartoon hammer would jump out of my ice cream and hit me in the head. But you know, this isn't a cartoon. This is for real. The pain that I get right here is spelt O-W-W-W. Ow! Exactly. So I think some serious scientific investigation is called for. And as you can see, I've already made a small start. And I can report that it doesn't matter what flavour the ice cream is, it still gives me a pain right here. I can also report that the double chocolate super supreme is just primo. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. Now, maybe it's not just ice cream that gives you that pain up here. Maybe it's any old dessert. And you know, somebody's just going to have to put it to the test. Okay, I can tell you with authority that no matter how many of these sweet treats I tried, none of them give me quite the same pain in the head that ice cream does. They maybe give me a wee pain down here on my tummy, but not up here in my head. Okay, I think it might be time for a wee lie down. Oh, I've been thinking about this deeply, and I really only get the pain when it touches a certain part of my mouth. Right at the back, up in the roof of my mouth. But why is that? What's up there, You know how underground there are wires for electricity and telephones and pipes that move water and stuff around? Well, under the surface of our bodies, there are lots of tiny little things like wires and pipes too. The pipes are called blood vessels, and blood vessels carry blood all around our bodies. And the things like telephone wires are called nerves. And when a message has to go from one part of our body to another, it zips along a nerve.
If I put my hand out towards something hot like this heater, you don't have to get too close because this thing is pretty hot. The nerves at the end of my fingertips can feel that heat, and they send a message to my brain saying, "Hey brain, we're getting close to something hot." Well, my brain sends a message straight back saying, "Hey Suzy, don't you get any closer." So I don't.
Of course, there are blood vessels and nerves running everywhere underneath the surface of your body. And if you look closely enough, you can even see some of those blood vessels as they carry blood underneath the surface of your skin. See? Here's one there. And there's one. And there's one. Of course, you can't see the nerves that are sending messages around my body underneath my skin because they're way too small. But they're there all right. They run down my arm and up my arm and all over the place. And you know, sometimes they can be a bit tricky. Did you know that if your leg gets tapped here just below your knee, the nerves here send a message all the way up your body to your brain to say, "Hey, we've just been tapped." And your brain sends an instant message all the way back down through your nervous system to your knee to say, "Oh, well hang on, why don't I show you? You just give my knee a gentle tap just here." Oh, sorry, see what I mean? But nerves can be tricky in other ways too. Because it turns out that one of the places that has quite a few nerves is, is right at the back of your mouth, right on the top there. It's called your palate. No, not your plate. It's called your palate. And there's a whole bunch of nerves there, right at the back. No, hang on. You can't actually see them. You'll have to take my word for it. They're right up there,
And they're very sensitive nerves, they are. If you're mean to them and if you call them nasty names, well, quite frankly, they'll cry! Okay, I'm just kidding about the crying bit, but they are very sensitive. And if you put something cold there for a long period of time, then they go into major panic. You might like to compare those sensitive little nerves with the nerves at the top of my arm. These guys are tough. How tough? Well, let me show you. They're this tough. Well, the message my nerves are sending to my brain at the moment is, it's cold, but really it's not that cold. And now the message they're sending is, do you know what? It's starting to run down the inside of my arm and the outside. It's a bit sticky. Is this really necessary? And of course, another part of my brain is sending the message, Suzy, you are wasting perfectly good ice cream. What are you doing this for? And that's a very valid point. So let's stop the investigation right now, okay? Okay, so the nerves here at the top of my arm didn't seem too troubled about having ice cream held up against them. In fact, they were pretty cool about it. Well, let's see what happens to the nerves in the roof of my mouth when something cold is pressed against them. Oh, but I'm not going through that ice cream pain again, no way. I'm going to use my lovely assistant here. I have a model of my head complete with the nerves that are connected to the roof of my mouth, see? Isn't she pretty? Say, hello, Suzy.
Hello, Suzy.
Well, let's see what happens when that cold, cold ice cream is pressed against the nerves on the roof of her mouth. Okay, here goes. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Action stations! Well, it's all panic in this bunch of nerves just above the mouth. They don't like it one bit, and they're firing off frantic messages left, right, and centre. Whew. Well, doctors aren't exactly sure what's going on next, but what they think happens is those blood vessels in the roof of your mouth, when they get really, really cold, they get tighter and tighter, so it's hard to push the blood through. And those nerves get in on the act and they go, ow, this pushing the blood through is hurting. Now, I know what you're thinking. Mm-hmm. You're thinking, all that panicky nerve stuff is happening here inside my mouth, but I feel the pain here? What's going on with that? Well, I told you that nerves could get up to some pretty tricky business. And as it turns out, the nerves in here that are going, ow, that hurts, are actually connected to the nerves up here at the front of your head. So when you're feeling pain from ice cream here, there's nothing wrong going on here. In fact, there's nothing wrong going on anywhere. It's just those nerves inside sending off panicky messages when they feel the cold for too long.
If you'd like information about this program, or if you have questions you'd like answered, you can write to us at Suzy's World, PO Box 34307, Birkenhead, Auckland, or head to the website www.suzy.co.nz.
If you sometimes get that pain in your head from eating too much ice cream, there are a couple of ways you can avoid it. You can try eating your ice cream slowly. Or you can try keeping the ice cream away from the back of the roof of your mouth. And if the worst comes to the worst, you're in the middle of a double-decker, double-chocolate, double-coned ice cream and you get that ooh, ah feeling. Try pressing your tongue up against the back of the roof of your mouth and see if you can warm up those little nerves that are so, so sensitive. Now, doctors think they know why ice cream gives you a pain in the head. They're not sure, but they think they know. And you know, that's fair enough. They've probably got far more important things to figure out. And besides, I'm happy to carry on the investigation myself. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, you're thinking, all this movie panic, okay. It's pretty hot. The fingers at the end of my nerves.
This program was brought to you by New Zealand On Air.